Santham Academy. Welcome to Digital Kaksha. To get updates on new videos, click the subscribe button and the bell icon.
Hello everyone, how are you all? Now, today I'm your teacher with a new topic, versatile nature of carbon. We have done till allotropes of carbon. Today we are going to study versatile nature of carbon. Now here, what does versatile means? Versatile means in our language it's all rounder. Like if suppose a child is good in everything like dancing, singing, studies, academics, everything, he's just all rounder. He knows each and everything of each field. That means we say that he is a all rounder. That means he has a versatile nature. Similarly, carbon is also having a versatile nature. Now what is the reason behind its versatile nature is the existence of large number of organic compounds is due to the following nature. Why carbon is versatile? Because it has millions of compounds in the whole universe. It is the only element which has this many compounds. The reason behind the nature, versatile nature, is the first reason is catenation. Catenation is self-linking property of carbon, means carbon can form a bond with carbon atom. Other elements also do catenation, like when we talk about phosphorus, P, then P combines with 4 phosphorus atoms, it forms P4 molecule. In this also phosphorus is showing catenation. Then sulfur, when we talk about sulfur molecule is S8, that means 8 molecules of sulfur are linked together. So here also sulfur is showing catenation. Oxygen as ozone, it has O3, that means 3 oxygen atoms are linked together. But after 4, after 8, after 3, these are the limitations of them. After 4 phosphorus, 5th one will not come and make a bond with P. That means some elements show catenation, but not to that much extreme level. Carbon can combine with million number of carbon atoms. So although these elements are showing catenation, but to limited number of atoms they are showing catenation. But carbon is versatile because carbon is joining with million number of carbon atoms. Also it has linking capacity in different way, that is it can form a straight chain. Like here carbon is forming a straight chain, 3 carbons are joined in a straight chain, that is propane. Here the carbon is, this is the main chain with 3 carbon atoms, but 1 carbon is in branch, so carbon can be attached in branch also. So this is 2-methylpropane. Also carbon atoms can join in a ring also. Here this is 6 carbons are joined in a ring, that is cyclohexane. So although it is having self-linking property, along with the self-linking property, it can form a long chain, it can form a branch chain also, it can form a cyclic chains also. This is a major reason for forming of a versatile nature. After catenation, next property is tetravalent nature. Tetra means 4, valent means valency. Carbon has valency 4, or it has a tendency to make 4 covalent bonds. Now the thing is that it can form multiple bonds with itself or the other atom. Multiple means single bond, double bond, triple bond. Like for example, this is chloroethane. Chloroethane, that means here carbon is bonded with chlorine, also carbon is bonded with carbon, and carbon is bonded with hydrogen. So we can say that carbon has made 4 bonds over here, single bonds, as carbon has a valency 4, that is it is tetravalent in nature. This carbon, when we see, it is also forming 4 covalent bonds with 3 hydrogen and 1 carbon. So this shows that carbon has a self-linking property, it is linking with itself, also it is linking with other atom by a covalent bond. So this proves a covalent and tetravalency of a carbon. Secondly, ethanol. Here, al represent aldehyde group, that is C double bond OH. Here we can see that carbon is making a double bond with oxygen. Carbon is making a single bond with carbon, and this carbon is making three single bonds with hydrogen and one single bond with carbon. So here also carbon is having multiple bonding, and each carbon is having four bonds, which proves its tetravalent nature. Again, moving on to this example, CH2 double bond CH2. This is ethene, since it has double bond in it. So here it proves that carbon has a tendency to form a multiple bond, double bond with itself, that is carbon only. And when we check the valency, this carbon has made four bonds, two over here and two with hydrogen, which proves its tetravalent nature. Next example is ethyne. So in ethyne, this CH triple bond CH, carbon is again forming a multiple bond with itself, and when we see its number of bonding, this carbon has made 3 plus 1 hydrogen 4 bonding, which proves its tetravalent nature. That means carbon in total will make 4 bonds, as it is tetravalent. It has a valency 4. It has a capacity to share 4 number of electrons. Now the next topic is allotropes of carbon. What is allotrope? Allotrope means the compounds which are made up of a single element, same elements. Allotropes of carbon, the phenomena in which the element exists in two or more different physical states with similar chemical properties, that phenomena is called as allotropy. When we talk about carbon, then the carbon has three allotropes: diamond, graphite and Buckminster fullerenes. So we are going to study the properties of diamond and graphite, and we'll come to know that what is allotrope. Allotrope is a compound which is made up of single element, same element, but they have different physical properties. Like when we talk about diamond, then diamond has a 3D structure and it is the hardest substance known to us. It is also act as insulator, and it is used for making jewelries. When we see the structure of diamond, then diamond has a tetrahedral unit in it. Means in diamond, each carbon is attached with 4 carbon by a covalent bonding, and the bonding is very strong. Because of this strong bonding, the carbon, this diamond, is said to be hardest substance, and it has a 3D structure. Means if we talk about this carbon, then this carbon is also going to attach with 4, 1 here and 3 more carbons. So this will form a long group of CH4 unit. So therefore it is the hardest substance. Now why it is acting as an insulator? Why it is not conducting? Why it is not conducting electricity? Because when we check carbon, carbon has atomic number 6, electronic configuration 2, 4. So carbon has in the last shell 4 electrons, and that 4 electrons are being involved in the bonding. 4 carbons in 4 bonds. So therefore no electron is free, and we know that electricity can only flow because of the presence of charge. Since here there is no charge free, so the carbon is not going to conduct electricity. Now let's check the another structure, another allotrope of carbon, that is graphite. Graphite is also only made up of carbon atom. Now if we see the structure of graphite, then the graphite has this packed hexagonal rings of 6 carbon atom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 carbon atoms is a hexagonal ring, and so many hexagonal rings are attached to each other, and it forms a layer. So we can say that graphite has hexagonal ring layers. So this is one layer, this is another layer, and in between these layers there is a weak bonding, which I have shown by this dots. This weak bonding is van der Waals force of attraction. This is the weakest force of attraction. वान डर वाल्स फोर्स दैट मीन्स सरफेस टू सरफेस इंटरेक्शन. सिंस दिस अट्रैक्शन इज़ वेरी वीक बिटवीन द लेयर्स ऑफ ग्रेफाइट, देयरफॉर द ग्रेफाइट इज लूज इन इट्स स्ट्रेंथ. द ग्रेफाइट कैन बी ईजिली कन्वर्टेड टू पाउडर. सो हियर ओनली वी कैन सी द डिफरेंस. डायमंड वॉज द हार्डेस्ट एलिमेंट एंड ग्रेफाइट इज नॉट सो हार्ड. नेक्स्ट इज इट इज़ अ गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. नाउ व्हाई? बिकॉज हियर व्हेन वी सी द स्ट्रक्चर देन वी सी दैट कार्बन इज बॉन्डेड विथ थ्री बॉन्ड्स. ईच कार्बन इफ यू सी लाइक हियर इट्स बॉन्डेड विथ थ्री एटम्स ऑफ कार्बन. बट वी नो दैट कार्बन हैज़ फोर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन द लास्ट शेल. थ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर इन्वॉल्व इन बॉन्डिंग. सो वन इलेक्ट्रॉन इज फ्री ऑन ईच कार्बन. सिंस ईच कार्बन हैज़ वन इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्री, आई हैव मेड दैट वन इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्री बाय अ पिंक कलर डॉट. सो दिस पिंक कलर डॉट रिप्रेजेंट वन इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्री ऑन ईच कार्बन एटम. सिंस वन इलेक्ट्रॉन इज फ्री ऑन ईच कार्बन एटम, देयरफॉर ग्रेफाइट इज अ गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. सो दिस इज अ बेस्ट वन ऑफ द रीजन. सेकेंडली वाई इट हैज़ लूज बॉन्डिंग ग्रेफाइट, बिकॉज इट हैज़ वान डर वाल फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन द लेयर्स ओवर हियर एंड दिस अट्रैक्शन इज द वीकेस्ट अट्रैक्शन, देयरफॉर ग्रेफाइट कैन बी ईजिली कन्वर्टेड टू पाउडर्ड फॉर्म. एंड ऑल्सो ग्रेफाइट इज एक्टिंग एज अ बेस्ट लुब्रिकेंट. Next structure is Buckminster Fullerene. This has a formula C60, means its one molecule is made by 60 carbon atoms, and in the structure of it there are 20 hexagons and 12 pentagons. It just look like a football. It has cage like fused ring structure. In that fused ring structure there are 20 hexagonal rings. Hexagonal rings means 6 carbon rings like this, and 12 pentagonal rings. Pentagonal means that's 5 carbon atom ring. Now it is used as a anti-aging and anti-damage agent in the cosmetic drugs sector, and it is also used in medicine, and it has so many further uses. So these are the three allotropes of carbon which we have discussed. Now we'll meet in the next video. Till then, goodbye. Thank you everyone.
Thanks for watching. If you like this video, make sure to like, share and subscribe for more.